Yes, in today's lecture in EE352 Power Systems, the topic of today's lecture is Power Flow Analysis. So, what is Power Flow Analysis? What we are going to learn in Power Flow Analysis, that how the power is flowing from generating station to the distribution section. So, in this topic, we will discuss about the different matrices, that is Y-bus matrix, and how to create Y-bus matrix for analyzing the power flow on a transmission line. For that, first we will discuss about the primitive network. So, what is primitive network? A power network is essentially an interconnection of several two-terminal components such as generator, transformer, transmission lines, motors and load. So, it is essentially a interconnection of several two-terminal components. That is the main thing. Each element has an impedance. The voltage across the element is called voltage element or element voltage, and the current flowing through the element is known as the current element. A set of components, when they are connected, form a primitive network. So, this is an representation of a power system and corresponding oriented graph. This is a power system, representation of power system and the corresponding oriented graph. Here you see, this is bus number 1, 2, 3 and 4. These are the generator section. We can take as a generator or generator section. This is transformer. These are transmission lines and these are bus bars. So, from this simple power system network or a power system representation of power system, we convert it into a oriented graph. So, how we convert this into oriented graph is simply, first we take the bus number, that is bus 1, 2, 3 and 4. So, this is a node taken as bus number 1, 2, 3 and 4, and we take a reference bus, say 0. So, from here, the bus 1 is connected to the reference bus, and we take the angle, the direction of the arrow represents the current incoming to the bus bar, and the direction of outgoing represents the current flowing outward from the bus bar. So, the reference node, from the reference node, the node are bus 1, 2 and 4. You see from here that bus 1 is connected to a generator, bus 2 is also connected to a generator and bus 4 is also connected to a generator. So, current is entering in these points. We can take it as, and the other thing, say bus 1 and bus 2 is connected, bus 1 is connected to bus 2 here by a element or a transmission link. We gave it number 6. So, first we gave the number 1, 2, 3, then 1 is connected to 2, same as 2 is connected to 4, bus 2 is connected to 4, bus 2 is connected to 3, bus 2 is connected to 3, bus 3 is connected to 4, bus 3 is connected to 4. So, by this way, we draw a oriented graph, or simply like this, say, this is bus 1, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, here it is reference. So, 1, 2, and 4. 1, 2, and 4 is connected to the generator. That is reference node. Current is entering. Now, 2 is connected to, oh sorry, 1 is connected to 2, so 1 is connected to 2. Using the current flowing through this direction, then 2 is connected to 3, 2 is connected to 3, 3 is connected to 4, 2 is directly connected to 4. Now we give this 1, 2, 3, and then 4, 5, 6, and 7. By this way, we can convert this power system, representation of power system, into oriented graph. Same thing, this is oriented graph which is shown in the previous slide. Now from this graph we make a matrix. The connectivity various elements to form a network can be shown by a bus incidence matrix, that is A. So how we form the bus incidence matrix from this oriented graph? So here we take the bus and here we take the links that are connected to different buses. Now bus 1 is connected to 1 connected to 1. So here what we are taking, that if the current is, if the direction of arrow is incoming to the bus side, we take it as minus 1, and if it is outgoing, then we take it plus 1. So here you see that the node 1, 1, that is the connected, the direction of arrow is incoming to the bus side, so we take it as a minus, and 1, 6. 1 and this 6. So here the arrow is outward side from the bus 1, so it is plus 1. Same if we take 2, node 2, so this one will be minus, and the node 2 is connected to connected to the different transmission link, that is 5, 6 and 7. So here you see this is 5, link is out, is having outward direction, so here we take plus, link 6 is having a direction which is incoming to the bus 2, so we take it minus. Link 7 is having outward direction, so we take it plus. So by this way, if we go for bus number 3, so bus number 3 is connected to 4 and 5 only, 4 and 5 element, and these elements are having incoming direction to the bus 3, so we take it as a minus 1, minus 1. Same as for bus 4, so the bus 4, what we are having element 3 which is minus 1, element 4 outgoing plus 1, element 7 incoming minus 1. So by this way we can form a bus incidence matrix which is represented by A. So from oriented graph we first convert it to bus incidence matrix. Now, the element voltages are referred as V1, V2, V3, V4, V5, V6 and V7. And element currents are referred as I1, I2 up to I7. In the power system network, bus voltages and bus currents are of more useful. For the above network, the bus voltages are bus voltages. These are the bus voltages, which is represented by capital V. V1, V2, V3 and V4. The bus voltages are also measured with respect to ground, and the bus current are designated as capital I, and it is I1, I2, I3 and I4. So the element voltages refer to the bus voltages. Element voltages refer to the bus voltages are shown here. So if I want to represent the element voltage V1, that is small V1, with respect to bus voltage, that is capital V1, so V1 is equal to minus V1. This is small and this is capital. So if I want to represent the element voltage, that is V1 is equal to minus V1. Same as V2, minus V2, V3 minus V4, V3 minus V4, V4, this one, V4. Now, see, this is V4, this is V4, V3. So, V4 is equal to V4, capital V4 minus capital V3. Same as V5, it is in between bus 2 and 3. So, V2, capital V2 minus capital V3. V6, V1 minus V2. V7, V2 minus V4. So, by this way, we can represent the element voltage. Now, expressing the relation which we have get in previous slide into matrix form, these are the element voltage, these are the bus voltages, and what we get, that is small V1 is equal to minus V1, small V2 minus V2, small V3 minus V4, and so on we get. So how to express this into matrix form? So here we take bus element voltages and we take bus voltages, and here we put the transpose of bus incidence matrix. So I think first we will draw this. What we are having? We are having, that is V1 is equal to minus V1, V2 is equal to minus V2, V3 is equal to minus V4, 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 V4 is equal to V4 minus V3, sorry, this is small. V5 is V2 minus V3, V6, V1 minus V2 and V7, V2 minus V4. So, this is the expression we derived earlier. So, now we form a matrix. So, here V1, if we compute this matrix, and what we get, V1 is equal to this multiplied by this minus V1. So by this way we get these matrices, and if we analyze this expression or relation, what we get that small v is equal to A transpose V bus, where small v is the bus element voltage, AT is the transpose of the bus incidence matrix which we have derived earlier in earlier slides, and V bus, that is the bus voltages. Now the elements currents are related to the bus current. Previously we derived the element voltages, now we get a relation, we want to get a relationship between element current and bus current. So here you see I1 capital I1 I2 I3 I4 is the bus current, and small I1 I2 I3 I4 I6 I7 is the element current. So I1 is equal to I1 small I1 plus I6. What we are taking, that if the current is incoming, we take it minus, the minus sign, and if it is outgoing, we take plus sign. Same as for I2, minus I2 plus I5 minus I6 plus I7. Because the I5 and I7, now we derive the current expression. Here capital I1, I2, I3 and I4 is the bus current, and small I1 up to I6 is the bus element current. Now you see I1, capital I1 is equal to minus I1 plus I6, same as I2 current. In case of I2 current, at this bus element current I2, element current I6 are incoming, and element current I5 and I7 are outgoing. So I2 and I6 are taking minus sign, and I5 and I7 are taken plus sign. Same as and I3, both the current are incoming, I3 and I4, and so we have taken minus sign. At I4, I3 is incoming, I4 is outgoing, and I7 is incoming. So by this way we write the expression. Now this is the expression. Now we convert this expression into matrix form. So this is the bus current, and these are the element current. So from I1 is equal to minus I1 plus I6. Same as from expression we convert it into matrices form, and we take we get a relationship, that is I bus, bus current is equal to incidence matrix multiplied by the bus element current. Element current, this is bus current. Now we get the bus voltage as well as bus current expression. Now the element voltages and element impedances are related as, this is element voltages, element current, and the matrix is representing the impedance matrix. Here 11 or ZII is the self impedance of the element, and ZIJ is the mutual impedance between the element I and J. So these are the self impedance, and non diagonal are the mutual impedance between the element. X and Y are say I and J. So the matrix notation from above, what we get, the bus voltages is equal to impedance multiplied by sorry, the small v is element voltage is equal to impedance multiplied by element current. Here Z is known as primitive impedance matrix, and the inverse form of above, that is I is equal to YB, and here Y is called the primitive admittance matrix. Matrix Z and Y, Z and Y are inverse of each other. So by this way we get them. Similarly to the above two relationship, the term of bus frame, that is bus voltage, V bus is equal to Z bus, bus impedance matrix multiplied by I bus. Here V bus is the bus voltage vector, I bus is the bus current vector, and Z bus is the bus impedance matrix. And the inverse of this is I bus is equal to Y bus, V bus, and here Y bus is known as bus impedance matrix. So that is the important thing, that is Y bus is the bus impedance matrix. So now here we take the summary of derivation of bus admittance matrix. It was shown that V is equal to, we have already derived this expression, V is equal to, that is element voltage is equal to AT transpose of incidence matrix multiplied by V bus, bus voltage. I bus is equal to AI, I bus is the bus current multiplied by incidence matrix, I bus is the bus current is equal to incidence matrix multiplied by the element or current element. I is equal to YB, where Y is the primitive admittance matrix, V is the element voltage, I is the element current, and I bus is equal to Y bus, V bus, as we have just now taken. So substituting the 2.7 equation in, so substituting the this I here, so we get I bus is equal to A YB, and now substituting the V, this expression here, what we get, I bus is equal to A Y A P V bus. Now comparing these expression, what we get, Y bus is equal to A Y A P. So this is the general formula for bus admittance matrix and admit mutual coupling between the elements. So by this way we derive the bus admittance matrix. In the power system problem, mutual coupling will have negligible effect and often omitted. In that case, the primitive impedance matrix Z and the primitive admittance matrix Y are diagonal, and Y bus can be obtained by inspection. This is here. This is the Y bus matrix. Y bus matrix, a primitive Y bus matrix, and we only taken the diagonal element. They are the self admittances. So from this Y primitive matrix, we get Y bus is equal to A incidence matrix multiplied by primitive admittance matrix multiplied by transpose of admittance matrix. So if we write, expand it, A is equal to this matrix multiplied by transpose of incidence matrix. So what we get? We get this expression Y, and by taking the incidence matrix multiplied by the this expression, we get Y-bus matrix, that is the final answer for the Y-bus matrix. Now there is an easy approach for getting Y-bus matrix. Either we take the whole derivation, that is the best thing, and get the Y-bus matrix, or otherwise from the oriented graph we can also get the Y-bus matrix, that is the 4 buses 1, 2, 3, 4, and the others are the elements, bus elements. Now here you see, in case of that 1, 1 bus, at bus 1 there are two admittances are coming, y11 y66. Here at bus 2 1 2 3 4, y22 y55 y66 y77, at 33 y44 y55, at 4 y33 y44 y77. So this is the diagonal matrix, diagonal element of a matrix. They are the self admittance or self impedance, and the non diagonal elements are having the mutual admittance or impedance. So here you see at 1 2 or 2 1 connected to y66, same as 1 3 1 is not connected directly, 1 4 is not connected directly, so here we take 0. So by this way we create this Y bus, we can also create the Y bus matrix. So now there are some rules for to forming a Y bus matrix. Number 1, the diagonal element, the diagonal element that is YII, equals the sum of the admittance directly connected to the bus, directly connected to the bus, and the off diagonal element YIJ equals the negative of the admittance, negative of the admittance connected between the buses I and J. If there is no element between buses I and J, then YIJ equals to 0. So these are, this is the rules to framing a Y bus matrix. So by the this is all about creating a Y bus matrix.